I'm Tyson from the Chainsaw Kittens, and we're at our manager's office in LA, off of Sunset Boulevard, right next to the Cat and Fiddle. If anyone knows where that is, it's like some hip bar and restaurant kind of hoo-ha.
And I'm Trent Bell, and this is the first time I've ever been to California, and I've noticed that every person here is in a band.
Or they look like that.
Yeah, well, everyone I met last night said they were in a band.
Oh, they were in a band?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So I said we're not.
The door is like it's a song about my sister's name is Connie, and when things were like kind of rough a few years ago and I didn't know what I was gonna do, I was like, and she's like this person that I always like kind of ask for advice, and she buys me clothes when I can't afford to buy them for myself because she's a housewife and is married to like a civil engineer and likes to buy me Nikes if I want them and that kind of stuff. But anyway, I was like, you know, Connie, I don't know what I'm going to do. What am I going to do with my life? I'm like in my 20s and I just, you know, I don't want to be an office person, blah, 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 blah. And she's like, well, when you come against a wall, you just go along the wall until you find a door and go through the door instead of trying to wall over. And I was like, oh, okay. And then later, you know, when the Kittens thing really started happening, that advice popped back into my head, and it's like we'd really worked really hard, but we didn't, you know, I didn't like panic and go, oh, I've got to do this or I've got to do that, you know. The Kittens just kind of, you know, kind of snowballed. In the band are from Norman, Oklahoma, which is a very liberal college town. But I came from Bartlesville, which is like uptight capital of the world, and it was pretty awful. And so I would just like kind of submerge myself and hide myself in rock scene magazines and read about the New York Dolls and you know, T-Rex and Kiss and Aerosmith and all that, because, you know, at my like junior high, if you weren't a football player, if you didn't kiss up to the football players, you were like a freak or whatever, and I was kind of a freak anyway. So yeah, Bartlesville was really awful. But then if I wouldn't have grew up there, maybe I would have, you know, just became an accountant if I would have grew up in like New York or something, you know. So yeah, it's pretty hideous. But it was made for good writing.
Bye.
there's definitely some inbreeding going on.
Yeah, there's definitely some moms and dads or sisters and brothers, you know. It's definitely, you know, well, she's my sister, but she's my mom, and, you know, it's kind of frightening. There's a, I don't think it's as bad as Arkansas, though, but it's kind of, they're kind of neck and neck.
But at the same time, the small towns, you get some of the weirdest people who are, like, totally into the band, too.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, there's really some really cool people in small towns, too, that, like, you know, you'll have a waitress at the Huff and Puff Diner or something, and she'll be like, oh, you're in a band? Can I have your autograph? You know, and that's all she, I mean, she's never been out of that town, you know, like Juan, Oklahoma or whatever.
The girl,
you know,
in the emergency room. Remember her?
Oh, yeah. Like, we, I got beat up, and we were, and so I was getting, like, stitches put in my cheek, and so Trent took me to the emergency room, and I was, like, signing autographs to, like, these frat boys, and they're like, oh, you're in the Chainsaw Kittens. Oh, cool, we listened to you at our house.
Why'd you get beat up?
Because some guy said, you know, I'm gonna kick that little faggot's face in, and he did.